I am Saitech and welcome back to my channel Saitech, where in today's tutorial or do the CPU throttling test comparison between the iQOO 7 versus the POCO X3 Pro device. Yes friends, finally got the POCO X3 Pro which has got the Snapdragon 860 processor, and iQOO 7 we do know which has got the Snapdragon 870 processor. Let's see friends, if you compare both processors side by side, what will be the performance and what will be the throttling, that is what I'm going to check in this entire video. So in case if you want me to do any other comparison, so make sure to comment below. So definitely I'll try to do those kind of comparisons in my channel. So first thing is that I'm trying to use both phones are 8GB RAM variants only in this test I'm trying to use. Let me do quickly open, and this is my first time doing the another benchmark test in the POCO X3 Pro. Yes friends, this is my first time and this is my day one of using this device, and let's choose the options up to 100 threads and 15 minutes I'm trying to use. As you can see exactly, so everything I set to the same settings in this both phones. As you can see friends, same settings in both phones. So let's see what will be the Snapdragon 860 is capable of getting this kind of results. And this is my first time doing this kind of test, as I said. I'll try to keep the brightness close to 50%. So now both phones are kind of close to 50% only, as you can clearly see. So I'm not trying to increase more brightness. So now let me try to start the test. So right now the battery percentage is also kind of close to 94 and 956, as you can see, 94 and 56. So first let me try to start and then check the temperatures. Yes, good, get set, go. I'm not trying to use any kind of game turbo or any kind of ultra game mode during this time of testing, and right now the temperature is pretty normal. My room temperature is also very normal, it's only 29 degrees, it's not that high, and my phone temperature is also very good, so it's kind of close to room temperature only, 29 and 30 degrees. And POCO X3 Pro, which has got kind of close to the temperature of 31 degrees right now. So let's see which phone will be heating a lot. That is what I'm going to check in this kind of testing. So 30 degrees, as you can see, 30 and 30. So right now both phones are started to increase slightly the temperatures, but let's focus on the graph. So how the graphs are behaving in both phones. Let's see what's the graphs are behaving. So right now you can see friends the graph, so which looks completely good on the iQOO 7 device in terms of the performance wise, but we'll come into the conclusion only at the end of the test, then we can actually decide so which phone has got what type of results. And if you look at the clock speeds, so this is another thing which I need to focus recently, which is the clock speeds on each and every core. So you can see, so 1.80 GHz on the iQOO 7 and 1.78 GHz on the POCO X3 Pro, and 2.41, 2.41 and 2.41. So everything is 2.41, and last one is 3.18 GHz and 2.95 GHz. As you can see the clock speed, so there is a slight difference between the clock speed. Apart from that, there is nothing much difference, major thing. So right now the POCO X3 started to decrease, but again it's kind of maintaining, and at this moment the iQOO 7 is kind of performing really good. So it's kind of maintaining around 3,30,000, as you can see friends, 3,30,000 in the iQOO 7 device. That's kind of not bad. So I'll try to do this kind of comparison from the POCO X3 with other smartphones as well in my channel, so make sure to stay tuned for more updates. And right now the graph, you can see friends, in both phones how the graphs are behaving, and the POCO X3 suddenly decreased in the middle. So let's check the temperatures after 3 minutes of continuously testing, after 3 minutes, and right now the 36 degrees in the iQOO 7, so 36.2 is the highest so recorded in this phone. And in the POCO X3 Pro has got kind of close to, I think, 34, not bad, 35.6. As you can see, the temperature is 35.6. So slightly temperatures are higher in the iQOO 7 device. Yes, in the iQOO 7, I did find the slightly the higher temperatures. That's the one thing which I did observe in the iQOO 7 smartphone. So again, I'll be back after maybe close to 10 minutes of time, or maybe 10 minutes of time, that will be kind of good. So at 10 minutes, let's check which phone will be having what kind of heat and temperatures. As you can see friends, I started to see the performance decrease in the POCO X3 Pro. I'm not sure why all of a sudden it got completely decreased, as you can see in the POCO X3 Pro friends. So in this phone, in the POCO X3 Pro, it decreased and it came close to 60% as well, the throttling. So a lot of people, they are planning to buy this phone for the gaming. I need to test the while gaming as well, so make sure to stay tuned for the gaming reviews. So definitely I'll try to do those kind of reviews as soon as possible, testing the gaming capabilities of this phone. So stay tuned for more updates. So right now the temperature is about close to only 37.8 degrees, not much, 35.2, 36.4, 36.8 only. The temperature is slightly higher in the iQOO 7 device, only 2 degrees, but you are getting really stable performance. The complete performance is really stable in the iQOO 7 device. So at this moment I did see this kind of change in terms of the graph and everything, as you can see here. So I'm going to be back after a couple of minutes. So right now, as you can see, friends, we are getting close to 15 minutes as well. Right now, it's kind of 13 minutes exactly. And you can see the graphs how it is. So between the Snapdragon 860 versus the Snapdragon 870 processor, you can clearly see that how much difference it is there between this both processors. I do know these both phones are completely a different kind of price range, but still, so there's a lot of difference in the graphs. I need to do some kind of testing on the Poco X3 Pro in terms of the performance. So I'll try to do plenty of other gameplay tests as well in my review, and I'll be back very soon. So 38 degrees, not bad, 38.6, and in the Poco X3 Pro, we are getting about 36.6, only 36 degrees till now it got recorded. As you can see, only 36 degrees, 36.8, that's it. In the iQOO 7 only, we are seeing about 38. So overall, 2 degrees. So 2 degrees is kind of slightly more in the iQOO 7 device every time. So we do this kind of throttling test. That's what the conclusion is. But I'll try to keep an eye on this Poco X3 in terms of the performance wise. Is it good phone for the below 20,000 rupees or not? So is it worth to buy or not? That is what my main motive of doing this kind of testing. So right now the throttling has been completely successful in both phones as well. And you can see the CPU throttled up to 91% in the iQOO 7 device, as you can see. But in the Poco X3 Pro, it got throttled up to 68%. As you can see, this is my first time doing this kind of testing in this phone. I need to take the screenshot and keep it in the gallery, so next time I can actually compare with other smartphones. But overall, like, I'm seeing plenty of throttling is happening in this phone. And right now I did not update to the MIUI 12.5. It's still running only MIUI 12. That's the one thing which I thought of mentioning here in terms of throttling. And the temperatures are slightly higher in the iQOO 7 device, 38.6 degrees and 36.2 degrees, 36.4 degrees in the Poco X3 Pro smartphone in terms of the temperatures wise. Slightly 2 degrees are more in this phone. But the performance is really very insane in the iQOO 7 device, as you can see. It's a lot, so much of performance in the iQOO 7 smartphone. You can clearly see the difference between both phones, as you can see, friends. So in case if you have any other queries regarding the smartphone, so make sure to let me know in the comment section below. So definitely I'll be able to help you out in case if you want me to do any other testings between these both phones. But I'll try to focus on the mainly speed test comparison and other aspects between the Poco X3 Pro versus the iQOO 7 device, which I'll be trying to do today if possible. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video, friends. Until then, stay tuned for more updates. Bye.